It's Saturday Night Football. Anthony Hudson here broadcasting live. Tonight we're here at Optus Stadium. Accompanying me is Gary Lyon.
Hi, Hutto. Always a pleasure to call a game with you.
Tonight, West Coast and the Power. They run on in full confidence, they're looking sharp, and the crowd are appreciating it. The banners are ready for the players.
It's going to be a big challenge for the Port Adelaide defense. They can win their battles one-on-one inside the 50. They should be able to keep their opposition to a low enough score.
They run on in full confidence, they're looking sharp, and the crowd are appreciating it. The cheer squad's hard work is paying off. The banners are looking great. The captains of both sides make their way to the middle for the coin toss. West Coast wins the toss. Round 20. Players head to their positions as we prepare for the opening bounce. Taps it down. He's got the football now. Hands that ball to the opposition. Farrell just threw it. Barris, one out in the square. He wins the ball in the air. Yo kicks it forward. Does well to cut off the kick. Burton goes with the kick. Finds this one all by himself. Got boot to ball. A chance to gather the ball. Quickly onto the boot. Takes a nice mark. Chose to kick it. Wines was surrounded. He needed to mark it, and he did. Needs a big kick if he's going to put this through. Go. Go for goal number one. Buzzard presents and takes the mark. 15 metres out. Takes aim, hits the post, and it's a behind. McGovern ready to bring it back into play. Uses it by foot. Well, it'll be a ball up near the boundary line. What can you tell us at this stage, Gary?
I'm really enjoying this one, Hutto.
He flicks it over, takes possession. Well collected, getting pushed out of the way was Watts. Houston going for distance with the kick. Decides to kick, a mark by Rockcliffe. Looks to move it by foot. Lysette takes the mark, uncontested. The kick ends up hitting the post. Port Adelaide by 2 points. Ready to bring it back into play. Plays onto himself. McGovern winds up and goes long. Kelly marks it. Moves it quickly.
Neither side able to hit the scoreboard early.
Drops the mark. Williams marks it with a bit of space. Manages to get a hand to it with the ball now. Hits him hard. Dixon puts on a big hit. Shepherd applying physical pressure. The loose ball picked up. Got the hands free. Wines shut him down.
Outstanding pressure.
Redden Campbells gets the ball out of heavy traffic. Goes with the kick. Takes that one strongly. Petrocelli going for number one. The drop back goes straight between the big sticks. Pretty happy with that one. The first goal of the match.
That came off the back of some good work. further up the ground. Some great ball movement there. You just knew they were going to score.
Aims for his man on the ground. Runs into a defender.
Fantastic pressure there. A great defensive effort.
Clears the ball from the contest. A stab kick from Burton. Burn Jones with an easy mark. Uses it across halfback. Goes by foot. The mark is taken by Chi. This will certainly test him from this distance. Go for goal number one. It always looked close. And it hits the post. West Coast beginning to apply their supremacy on the scoreboard with a lead of 7-2. Considering the options on the kick in, Jonas lays it to himself. Puts boot to ball. Gathers it now. Can he put it through? Brayshaw sends it through the big sticks for a goal. Congratulated by his teammates. West Coast with the edge right now over Port Adelaide.
It's great to watch, Hutto. Plenty of excitement. This is how they can score big, Hutto. If they can do that on a consistent basis, it's massive.
Punches are clear. He gets his hands on the footy. Kelly couldn't complete the tackle. Shepherd lobs the handball. Kicks hurriedly. Takes the mark. Slams it onto the boot. Cleary gets a quick kick away. Dersma wins the marking contest. Looks up with a kick. Wines takes a strong mark. The distance might be just beyond him. Gets his first. Wines couldn't be happier with that goal. It's heating up at the moment. The Eagles are leading by 5 as we go to the break.
West Coast deserve this lead early. They'd want to keep it up if they're going to win this.
Time to take a look at the stats.
The Power needs to do a better job and gain more clearances at the moment. They're getting beaten in the contest and it's affecting the scoreboard.
Thanks, Gaz. The second term ready to get underway. Lysette does well. Gets a quick kick away. Shepherd dug it out. Shepherd will be the recipient of the free. Sinks the slipper into it. A race for the loose ball. Lysette throws the ball away. Spears the ball. He gives chase to the footy. Tries to release the pressure. He's got the footy in his hands. Trying to get some momentum with the kick. Buzzer delivers with a straight drop pass. That will settle his nerves. Gets his first on the ball. Look at him. He really enjoyed that one.
It hasn't always been clean, but they've got the goal. That's a really good team goal. When the forwards are marking the ball so cleanly inside 50 like they are now, it must give Port Adelaide a lot of confidence, especially when the pressure is on.
Clears the contest. Brace your on the ball. Darling couldn't snap it. Assessing the options, plays on from the kick-in. He drives it. Stuck the mitts out there and held on to it. Darling looks to build some momentum with this kick. A 45-degree angle for this shot at goal. Going for goal number one. That one hits the floor. Move as they look to provide an option. Wines leaps over the top, goes short by hand. He gets another possession, gets it away, fends off the tackler. Burn Jones just threw it, moves the ball by foot. Nananui wins the ball in the air. This will have to be his very best kick to score from this far. He slams it towards goal. Summed it up.
That goal will be a real confidence boost. You can see he's up and about now. He knew that was home as soon as it left the boot. West Coast aren't winning as much of the footy, but are still controlling the contest. Their efficiency with the ball is superior at the moment.
Thump clear. Opportunity for Motlop. Brings it out of the pack. Finds the target. Nananui a long way out. He drives it towards goal. Brilliant stuff. And he puts it through. Puts his second on the board. He loved that one. West Coast doing well at the moment.
They're looking more dangerous inside 50 now. Great reward for effort. He did really well there and gets the reward. Port Adelaide got actually on top in the contested positions. They just need to convert that dominance into scoreboard pressure.
Thrashes it. Is in his possession. Dixon wins the foot race. Finding the loose ball with Shepherd. A lot of possessions for him. Dersmak going for number one. No issues with that drop pass. Look at them celebrate that effort. Just under 2 goals the difference now.
Great bit of play that resulted in that. He knew that was home as soon as it left the boot. Port Adelaide are giving up too much free space on the opposition. They're allowing them too much room and easy contested ball.
Punched away. Did well not to confuse himself. He gains possession. Dersmak running off for a break. Ball up in the centre square. What can you tell us, Gaz?
This is a classic game we're seeing right now. Great attack on the ball carrier.
Marshall puts on a bump, finds the loose ball, slick with the hands. Kelly going for number one. A big contested grab. Kennedy takes the pressure of the goal kick upon himself. 20 metres out. He gives it a run. Celebrating hard. West Coast by 13.
That came off the back of some good work. Further up the ground. Great bit a play that resulted in that. West Coast have actually turned it over more than the opposition, but they haven't allowed that to translate into scores. It's why they're still in front.
Lysette won the hit out. Shuey just gets the kick away. Bounce works for Yo. It'll be a ball up. Lysette thumps it forward. He has the ball. Hurd dug out the loose ball. Hurd won himself a free. Uses a short handle. Missed the target. White finds his man on the move. Wins the race to the ball. Has to do better than that in the mark contest. Kicks it out of the back 50. Shepherd looks to get onto the football. The kick from Yo. Good mark there. Slams it on the boot. She takes a strong mark. With a driving kick. Petrocelli there to mop up. Has a runner alongside him. Kelly marks. Good opportunity for West Coast to put a goal through here. Might be too far out to score. The siren sounds, and that's the end of the term. The scores, West Coast 39 to Port Adelaide 20.
It's been a promising first half for West Coast. They'd be confident they can keep it going in the second half.
What stands out for you, Gaz?
West Coast are gaining a lot of their advantage through some smart kicks and even better marking inside their forward 50.
Thanks. The game promises plenty. We have a big second half coming up. A big second half about to begin. Swats it. And now winds. Rushes with the kick. Over the top of the pack. Farrell pumps it into the 50. The ball ends up with Touchlip. 30 metres out. Going for goal number one. Takes the chance and says thank you very much with that goal. Sutcliffe celebrating hard. Port Adelaide reduced the margin.
It's great to watch, Hutto. Plenty of excitement. Some great ball movement there. Just knew they were going to score. Port Adelaide giving themselves a chance on the turnover, but they can't seem to be putting it on the scoreboard.
Hammers it. He wins possession. Shows some physicality. Hartland uses the bump. Jonas slick with the hands. Has it now. High tackle. Burton with a drilling ball. Finds a bit of room to mark.
Well, when you look at the shots at goal, there just hasn't been enough scoring opportunities being created. Get the ball inside 50 and give your forwards a chance to take a mark. West Coast forwards are dangerous anywhere inside 50. They just need to be given a shot.
Duggan landed in his back on this occasion. Amon uses it by foot. Shepherd picks up the loose ball. Wine traps him up.
Fantastic tackle.
Schofield had it, lost it. Buzek suckers it home for a goal. They get around him after that effort. Port Adelaide close the gap to 7.
He did really well there and gets the reward. That goal will will be a real confidence boost. You can see he's up and about now.
Big thump from Lysette. Kelly hacking it out of there. Ends up marking and contest.
West Coast for allowing too many marks inside the opposition forward 50. They continue to get beaten in this area. They'll find it difficult to keep the lead.
Doing well to intercept that kick. Moves it by foot. Burton marks uncontested. Uses it now. Pau Pepper takes the mark. Puts it on the boot. The loose ball scooped up. Petrocelli going for number two. He's enjoying that goal. West Coast lead is now 13.
That's a really good team, though. They're looking more dangerous inside 50 now. Great reward for effort. Port Adelaide are doing well to control the ball in the air. They are getting to the right spots to cut off opposition attacks. They just need to be more controlled from this point forward.
Thumps it clear. Dersma collects it. Doing well with the mark. Moved on by Hearn. Brayshaw uses the body well. Elects to kick. Redden takes the mark.
West Coast have the lead, but they're allowed plenty of opposition marks inside 50. They need to fix up that aspect of their game if they're to stay on top.
Cripps heads towards the goals. Unbelievable effort, and it ends with a goal. Gets some reward for his efforts. That's two in a row for West Coast. The margin is 19.
This is how they can score big, Hutto. If they can do that on a consistent basis, it's massive. It hasn't always been clean, but they've got the goal. Port Adelaide just aren't running for each other or creating space to work into. And as a result, they haven't been able to earn many set shots inside 50.
Thumps it clear. Scoops up the ball. Ball stripped in the tackle. Rockledge hit the man hard. Rockcliffe free kick. Chips it towards half forward. Intercepts the ball well. Sinks the slipper into it. Collects the loose ball. Kick by Amon. A good mark under the circumstances. 40 metres from home. Going for goal number one. Slams it home. He's excited about that one. Port Adelaide behind by 13.
He did really well there and gets the reward. That came off the back of some good work further up the ground.
Nui thumped it clear. Kelly can't hold on to the tackle. Farrell has a great set of hands.
West Coast haven't been able to set up many set shots at goal, but I'm not sure that it's the forward's fault. The ball has been coming in way too slow. You can't expect your forward to kick a winning total that way.
We'll have another ball up. Can you tell us anything at the moment, Gaz?
This is a great game, Hutto, and we can just sit back and enjoy it.
He's leading the ranking points.
He's doing everything right.
Drives it out of the pack. Mockler didn't mark it. Rosie just goes bang, hit the man hard. The tackle deserves a free and gets it. Unable to create the space.
Great tackle.
A chance to put one through for his side. 40 metres from home. dropped more than two goals behind. As we go into the final change, the scores at West Coast 51, Port Adelaide 39. A big final term coming up.
West Coast will want to keep the foot on the accelerator and finish this last quarter strongly.
Plenty of scoring opportunities in the third term. It'll be interesting to see which team can capitalise in the final quarter. Natanui continues to dominate this contest.
He's the most dominant player on the ground at the moment.
One quarter of footy to go.
They have to go quickly to have any chance from here.
Hammers it. He gets his hands on the footy. There'll be a ball up in the centre square. Swats it. Didn't fumble. Fights the good fight. Goes by hand to Darling. Just dismisses his opponent. Handballs to a teammate on the run. Just gets it onto the boot. Buzzer urged on by the crowd. Prepares to kick. Buzzer has resources out wide. Wines works well on the boot for goal. Couldn't keep it straight on the line. It's offline. It's under two goals now.
West Coast could turn the ball over a lot trying to play aggressively. It's where they turn it over which doesn't make it as dangerous.
Hearn pushes a low ball. Steady hands there as he holds that one. This is McGovern. Dixon rushes with the kick. Barris collects the loose ball. Shuey drives a low kick. Gap wins the ball in the air. Goes for territory. Coughed up by Motlop.
I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
That's right, Hutto. He just can't seem to get into the game.
Kelly finds a way to hang on.
Great tackling there, Hutto.
It's a turnover. Charges with intent. Redden dishes it off. Slips the handball to Dixon. Both going for number one. Oh, what a goal! He celebrates hard after that. Port Adelaide now only trail by five.
This is how they can score big, Hutto. If they can do that on a consistent basis, it's massive. That goal will be a real confidence boost. You can see he's up and about now. Port Adelaide are playing a very controlling game. They're taking plenty of marks and denying the opposition possession.
Punches it clear. Great control there. Just put it on the boot. Takes a simple grab. Schofield drives the ball out of defence. Uses it across half back. Marks now and can send it back. Sutcliffe moves it now. Takes the mark all by himself. So what can Port Adelaide do with this opportunity in front of goal? Goes with the kick. Rockley, the better man there. 45 metres out. Bit of an angle for this kick. He drives it. Putting this one through would give Port Adelaide plenty of confidence. Big moment to get the lead with this kick. Smiles all around. Port Adelaide have kicked the last three goals. They've hit the front.
They're looking more dangerous inside 50 now. Great reward for effort. He knew that was home as soon as it left the boot. Port Adelaide are on top but are losing the contested possession count. It's one area of their game that needs some work.
Thrashes it. He wins possession. Yo knew what was coming. He's got the footy in his hands. He has the ball. Seen plenty of it. Off hands from Darling. I haven't seen him for a while, Gaz.
Maybe the coach needs to get on the phone to him and give him some instructions. Big tackle.
His teammates rush over. West Coast take back the lead.
That's a really good team, though. It's a Some great ball movement there. You just knew they were going to score.
Punched away. Kelly keeps coming. Williams throws the ball away. Uses it now.
Pushing it back.
Landed in his back on this occasion. Towards centre half forward. Dersma grabs that one. 40 metres from home.
Got the goal. A great bit of play that resulted in that.
Clears the contest, takes possession, sweeping handball. Mogdalen earns a free kick. A chance to put one through here for the power. Big kick required from this distance. Dersma is blowing hard after that effort. Just on the side of the post. Now they lead by two. Mugabe looking for options now. Decides to play on now. Chose to kick it. Takes an uncontested mark. Rabin goes short by hand. Kelly grabbed it clean. Barrett kicks hurriedly. Marks that ball uncontested. Venables was taken high in the tackle. Port Adelaide players devastated after a result like that.
Desperate and some special individual acts made this a classic match. The stars really shone tonight. The West Coast sky, I will to win, will never die. Red Eagles, the West Coast Eagles, here to show you why.
Final scores up 63-59. On behalf of Gary Lyon, thank you for joining us. We'll see you again soon.